A CTF is a competition with a variety of challenges, where you can go through some logical steps to get to the flag, which you can submit and claim points. If your team comes first, there's usually a cash prize. But before you dive head first, you need to understand that there could be anywhere from 10 to 100 of these challenges, all with different topics and set of skills. We'll get to that later. Similar to an escape room, the solving process usually involves a lot of just trying random things and seeing what comes of it. If there is a website with a login page, what would happen if I put some special characters to try and log in as admin? What's great is you don't even have to know the technical stuff. There are categories for people who treat scrolling through Instagram reels as a full-time job. If you're wondering where these tournaments happen, the answer is simple, ctftime.org. It's a giant calendar of upcoming events, and what you want to look for is online Jeopardy-style events. You don't have to sign up, and it even shows approximately how many teams will be competing in them. In reality, there are a lot more that participate on game day, but if you see an event with 50 plus teams signed up, you can be sure it is a popular one. In these events, you can find a variety of challenge categories. I align them into these sections. REV, short for reverse engineering, consists of decompiling a software file to make the program do anything you want it to. Basically for people who want to learn how to crack paid subscription software so they don't have to pay for it. Which is why it's in the neutral evil section. Forensics is about discovering and extracting hidden data in files or disks, mostly used in police work, which is why it's lawful good. Personally, it's not my favorite. While there is a lot of raw data, it's usually hard to visualize for beginners. Crypto is not the rug pull you think it is, and instead dealing with mathematical encryption algorithms. A lot of math and a lot of scripting with this one. OSINT is open source intelligence, and it's the closest thing to an escape room puzzle. It's basically a scavenger hunt across Google, and you get an initial hint. You have to know your social media and know how to use a search engine. It's quite chaotic because the flag could be anywhere in the billions of petabytes of the internet, but is neutral enough that a casual person can do it. Now, my favorite category, and you can probably guess what it is since it's chaotic evil, is web. Anything with websites, this is where you try to break login pages to become an admin or use built-in features to get access to the backend. Network challenges are something similar, but mostly focus on the connections from a server to a client user. How can you intercept traffic while it is going from point A to point B? You're still trying to break things, but more focusing on the protocols and systems that are in place. Stegosaurus over here is about finding hidden data inside image files. It's similar to cryptography in the sense that you have to understand algorithms that hide and decrypt data, but you just do it with pictures instead. There are other categories, but this is roughly how popular each one is from my experience, with web and reverse being most talked about. While you are waiting for the next big event, there are ways you can start practicing for them right after watching this video. There are many sites that allow you to sign up for free and try out practice challenges so that you know what to expect in the real thing. And what's great is these challenges have already been solved thousands of times, so it's very easy to find the solutions to them, or in other words, write-ups. For beginners, I recommend Pico CTF. It has a good collection of challenges from previous year's events, and you don't have to deal with setting up a VPN or proxy servers like some other sites. It's just a sign up, click start instance, and hack away. Speaking of VPNs, you might have already guessed that these events and sites attract a certain kind of people. Those who are very proficient in cybersecurity, and those who you don't always know the intentions of. So if you're gonna be doing any challenges that requires a connection to the internet, I highly advise using some sort of VPN and even virtual machine to protect yourself and your data. They don't take long to set up, so I won't be going over the how, but these are the examples. When practicing on a challenge, the worst thing you can do is look up the solution right after you come to a dead end. The best way to approach these is to try everything you know first, then turn to Googling keywords, and only after that, give up and Google the name of the challenge. This way, you always try to apply the techniques that you are progressively learning. And trust me, there are a lot of them. So you want to constantly try things that have already worked in the past so that you don't forget them. By the way, if you're looking for a cool internet riddle game, search up Not Prawn. It was made in 2004 and is still awesome. The levels increase in difficulty, and it includes a lot of what you could encounter in a CTF challenge. All right, let's pretend the event has already started. If you haven't already done so, always join the Discord of the specific event. They will have useful announcements, and you won't be confused when the site inevitably crashes since so many people are trying to open up the challenges. The infrastructure pretty much always lags in the first 20 to 30 minutes. As fast as the event started, it has already ended. And this is where the admins will leave the challenges up for a couple of more days, for you to share your write-ups in the Discord and try to break the challenges yourself. You obviously don't get any points, but it is the best time to learn about how people are smarter than you. Well, you have now been to a couple of events, you know what an SQL injection is, and are now ready to take on the hardest of challenges. This is where you need a team, who you can share knowledge with, and who can specialize in different categories, like a mage or a rogue, so that you don't have to be a jack of all trades. Sometimes, you can find a looking for team channel in the Discords. Personally, I have found mine just randomly looking through Reddit posts of other people like me trying to find a team. It might seem intimidating at first, but remember that you're all there to learn more about cybersecurity and how to break it. Overall, just treat it like a game. And so what if you're a couple of levels below everyone else? They all started where you are now at a certain point in time. Be on your way now. Have fun. Read the rules and stay safe.